When we talk about routing on the internet, it's important to acknowledge the fact that there's this special class of IP addresses out there that are referred to as private. They're also referred to as unroutable because computers on the internet, core internet routers, will not route traffic to these addresses. Now that may make them seem stupid or worthless, but it turns out that these addresses on today's internet play an incredibly important role in helping the internet scale. So I want to talk about them just briefly. There are several ranges of these addresses, and if you've configured a router, like a home router or home wireless router, you've probably encountered IP addresses that look something like this. 192.168.something.something, sometimes that's 1.1 or 1.2 or 1.100, and sometimes also 10.something.something.something. So these are private IP address ranges or unroutable addresses. So if you send a packet to a router on the internet and the destination starts with this prefix or with this prefix, the router will just drop that packet immediately because there are no entries in its routing table for these addresses. So why are they used? So let me point out something that's interesting. It turns out that the computer that I'm using right now is using an address in one of these private ranges. So this is the address. If you run a command on Mac called ifconfig, it will tell you about all the interfaces that you have configured. This is the interface I'm using to access the internet. And the internet address that's assigned to this interface is 192.168.1.13. So that's curious, right? This is a private IP address. It's unroutable. So if a computer on the internet tries to send me a message at 192.168.1.13, it'll never arrive because the core internet routers won't route to this address. But let me point out something else that's a little bit interesting. If I go to Google and Google, what is my IP address? What Google reports is my IP address is 128.205.39.97. It also says this is my public IP address. Now this IP address is routable. This is a normal IP address. It's in the UBIP range of 128.205. So this is weird, right? If I go to my own computer and I say, what's my IP address? The computer says 192.168.1.13. If I go to Google and ask Google, it says 128.205.39.97. So what's happening here? What's happening here is this computer is serving as a relay for my traffic to the internet. So this arrangement where I have a private IP address, but there's another computer I'm connected to, in this case, this is the wireless router that's located right here. That wireless router, this is the IP address of that wireless router. And so what that wireless router is doing is it's essentially serving as a middleman for me. So it allows me to connect to the internet. However, it does not allow any incoming connections to my personal computer. So this computer right here that has that private IP address that's assigned to it, 192.168.1.13, this computer cannot be a server because there's no way for another computer on the internet to contact me at this address. This address is private. And in fact, there's no requirement that these addresses be unique on the internet. So there are probably dozens, if not thousands, of computers online on the internet right now that have 192.168.1.13 as their address or something like that. Now, IP addresses are supposed to be unique. That's important because I'm routing to a particular destination. If a bunch of computers have the same address, how do I know where the packet's supposed to go? And so this is an indication that there is no way for me to run a server on this computer. However, private IP addresses do allow me to run clients like a web browser and other things, and so they allow me to connect to the internet. So as long as I'm originating the connection, these private addresses can be used. And it turns out that these private addresses are really important because we are running out of IPv4 addresses. So there are very few public IPv4 addresses that are left. The nice thing about the private addresses is it allows us to bring computers online with without giving them a public address. So as long as you don't run a web server or some sort of server that needs to handle incoming connections, and that's a lot of the computers that are connected to the internet, like your smartphone, your laptop, most of your desktop computers, you can use a private IP address safely. If you want to run a server, you're going to need a public IP address, and those are much, much harder to get. We'll come back and return to this topic when we talk about transport, and we talk a little bit about what's called network address translation, because network address translation is the process that allows me to safely use this private IP address and still access the rest of the internet.